Item number, SCP-169. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. Because of its size, SCP-169 cannot and almost certainly will never be contained. No structure on Earth is large enough or strong enough to contain SCP-169. The location of SCP-169 is not precisely known, but imaging satellites and analyses of eccentricities in the Earth's orbit suggest SCP-169 is located in the southern Atlantic Ocean, possibly stretching around the tip of South America. Any satellite footage of a shift in the landmasses produced by SCP-169 is to be excised and destroyed by embedded agents. Description: SCP-169 is surmised to be a marine arthropod of enormous size, known as the Leviathan by generations of sailors and oral history. Presumed at first to be a myth, SCP-169 was detected in 19... by Mobile Task Force Gamma-6 during an investigation of paranormal activity around an undisclosed archipelago. During Gamma-6's investigation, Dr. Gamma-60912 discovered the archipelago to have moved at least 3 kilometers from its original location. Though initially said doctor believed this motion to be due to unusually quick continental drift, a reconnaissance mission performed by the USS revealed the archipelago to be the protrusions of rock-like plates covering an enormous organic mass. The Foundation was brought in immediately to begin threat management. Dr. Gamma-60912 and Dr. Gamma-60421 estimate SCP-169's body length to be between 2,000 and 8,000 kilometers. The creature is thought to have existed since the pre-Cambrian era. No other specimens have been sighted. Almost nothing is known about SCP-169's habits, such as its reproductive capabilities, if any, food source, and nesting area, if any. Research regarding SCP-169 is pending approval. The archipelago known as the Islands have historically been uninhabited, though claimed by 17. Upon handover to the Foundation, their presence was evacuated on the pretense of rising sea levels. Though the archipelago has remained above sea level for several millennia, any change of depth by SCP-169 could result in the disappearance of the entire archipelago. SCP-169 moves slowly, less than 1 kilometer per week, but seems only to be adrift. Its method of propulsion is unknown. Regular seismic tremors seem to indicate breathing about every 3 months, causing minor shifts in the island's terrain, suggesting that the creature is probably dormant. Information suppression. The USS was scuttled with all hands immediately after the discovery of SCP-169, with the permission of the American government. The public is forbidden from entering the archipelago created by SCP-169, due to the conveniently large number of resident endangered bird species. As indicated above, satellite footage is to be doctored in order to suppress knowledge of SCP-169's movement. NASA is currently cooperating with the Foundation in keeping the existence of SCP-169 quiet, and is currently permitting the Foundation use of their satellites for photographic use. Addendum 0-20. In 1990, the U.S. National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, an American scientific agency, unaffiliated with and unaware of the existence of the Foundation, detected an ultra-low-frequency underwater sound emanating from an undisclosed location, approximately kilometers from the southwestern coast of South America. Despite the best efforts of embedded agent IA-1522, news of the sound leaked to the media, receiving significant media coverage. Foundation analysis concluded that a massive underwater organism was the source of the noise, and SCP-169 was hypothesized to be its source, as its head is well within the possible locations of the rest of SCP-169. The sound confirms Gamma-60421's hypothesis that SCP-169 is gargantuan in size. Future efforts by scientific or civilian teams to determine the source of the noise must be stopped by any means necessary. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-168, Sentient Calculator, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.